Welcome back, everybody, to the Charlotte Hornets My League here on NBA 2K20. As today, our Hornets are going to make some progress here for the month of January. And obviously, the season has not been too kind to us. We're likely just going to be rebuilding again. But the young guys are progressing. Anthony Edwards has been great. Miles Bridges has actually passed Michael Porter Jr. for second most points per game. Malik Monk just got hurt. I forgot to show it on camera, but he's going to be out 2 to 4 months, I believe, with a dislocated patella. So that sucks. We're losing our best bench scorer, a guy who's in a contract year. Just not an ideal situation with him. So do we bring him back this offseason? Let's determine that soon. But we have made a move, and it involves Terry Rozier. And we've been looking for a Rozier trade for a while. He is headed to the Phoenix Suns in exchange for a 2024 first-round pick, along with Tony Snell, and a $2.14 million exception. Terry Rozier just never really fit in, and he didn't really work out here. Obviously, we traded for Justice Winslow last year, and once that happened, Rozier was relegated to the bench. And this year's numbers have gone down even more, and he's sort of been the ninth man in this rotation. So I think it makes sense for a mutual divorce for the two sides. And meanwhile, Phoenix, he gets to be the permanent starter. The current starting point guard there, Ty Jerome, is hurt. Even when Jerome returns, I still expect Rozier to be the starter. So I think that makes sense for Phoenix, and I think it makes sense for Rozier. Then for us, we're getting his contract out of the way, getting a first-round pick along with the legend himself, Tony Snell. And that pick from the Suns means we have 5 first-round picks in the years 2023 and 2024 alone. So if this team were ever to make a big play when it comes to trading for a superstar, boom, plenty of future draft capital assets to move. So the Hornets are really doing a nice job of building these picks, which they can use eventually to make bigger moves. Here's a look at the standings, and the Eastern Conference is extremely close and tight. The Hawks are the 8th seed, barely 3 games back of a 1 seed. Our Hornets, 2nd to last in the conference, 10.5 back of a 1 seed, 7.5 back of the postseason. Only the Knicks are worst. And then in the West, the best team in the NBA is the Los Angeles Lakers, led by LeBron and Anthony Davis, the current 8th seed. Is the San Antonio Spurs, and the West doesn't look super deep like it normally does. Got some surprising teams like the Nuggets, the Blazers, the Clippers not in the playoffs, and look at the Jazz, they're the worst team in the NBA by a landslide. The only team with single-digit wins, which makes no sense because the Jazz are good. Donovan Mitchell has done his thing this year, and something to keep your eye on when it comes to Mitchell is he is on an expiring contract. He is restricted, and I expect the Jazz to match any offer for him, but why would Mitchell want to stay there? Couldn't he potentially request a trade? Could a team like the Hornets make a play for a guy like Donovan Mitchell? And then there's Mike Conley, also in the last year of his deal, and he's been exceptional as well. Obviously, he will not be as big of a get as a guy like Donovan Mitchell would. And then Rudy Gobert's been hurt, but he has been healthy for most of the year, so that's still no excuse to why the Jazz are so bad, as Gobert is the best defensive center in basketball, one of the best defensive players overall, and this team has a good supporting cast, Bojan Bogdanovic, Joe Ingles, and then some other younger guys like Dante Exum, Alex Len. Both of them were top 5 picks in their respective drafts. Both of them were actually number 5 overall on the dot. So, I don't know why this team is doing so bad, but we'll have to keep our eye on them as the NBA season goes along. And then, here's a look at the new rotation. Obviously, Rozier is gone. Obviously, Malik Monk is out. So, that opens up minutes for Devontae Graham and Jalen Nowell. Nowell is a talented jump shooter. Graham is an overall pretty good player, especially on offense. And Graham was solid off the bench. I think he was our best scorer who came with the second unit. And then a few more corresponding roster moves, Aaron Wiggins and Admiral Schofield. Neither of them have really gotten any playing time this year. So they are going to the G League. And it is New Year's Day. The Minnesota Timberwolves coming in nice. Andrew Wiggins and Naz Reid being shown here in their express suits. The Timberwolves set to take on the Charlotte Hornets. The kickoff of the 2021 year. As the Timberwolves, who are currently the 4th seed in the West, believe it or not, they've actually played really well this year, trying to continue to climb upon the potential playoff race. The Timberwolves did draft LaMelo Ball number 1 overall. He is out in this one, so Chris Dunn is their starter. Yes, they brought Chris Dunn back. Ouch. Let's start this game off with a nice little dunk from the second-year rookie Jarrett Culver. And then Karl Anthony Towns joining in on the dunk and fun as Minnesota off to a hot start. There's Naz Reid with the steal. And then Air Wiggins. Andrew Wiggins, the former Kansas Jayhawk, with the layup. Timberwolves up big early as there's Chris Dunn putting Miles Bridges on skates. Chris Dunn is a very offensively limited player, but made a nice move there as Miles Bridges gets the and one. Bridges has been a surprise this year. He put up good numbers last year, but with an improved team, I thought his numbers would go down, which they haven't. But Andrew Wiggins tells Bridges what you can do, I can do better, getting an and one of his own. There is Devontae Graham. Has not played a minute this season, believe it or not. His first shot of the campaign is good. And then there's Bismack Biyombo with the offensive rebound. Former Charlotte Hornet making that play. As the score is 23-9. Ouch. Jalen Nowell does try to pad the bleeding a little bit. He gets the three ball to fall. And then here's Josh Okogie, the Nigeria native, with a one-handed powerful slam. And then to beat the buzzer, Justice Winslow is showing off the ice in his veins. But not a good first quarter by any means for the Hornets, especially offensively. Let's go to quarter number two. There's the big fella, Bruno Fernando. Fernando was very good here in the second quarter, especially in the early part of the frame, as there's Chris Dunn for three. Devontae Graham caught sleeping on defense. And then Karl Anthony Towns, reservations for three, please. Cat with a very good game in this one, putting up 21 points and 10 rebounds. As here is the big man. The big man can. That's Bruno Fernando. 4-3, 7 points, 7 rebounds. Most of those came in this quarter. As here is Anthony Edwards now joining in on the fun. Big game for Edwards as he gets the steal. His first of 5 today. Then Edwards step back. He's going to get the 3 off, even though Culver's right in his face. And I told y'all Chris Dunn was an offensively limited player. Here's Andrew Wiggins putting the spin cycle on Bruno Fernando for the layup. 39-29 our score. Miles Bridges with another and one as the third-year man from Michigan State would get to the line to add another bucket. So now 41-32. Anthony Edwards more wide open than a McDonald's drive-thru at 5 o'clock in the morning. He nails a wide-open 3. Double-double in this game for Edwards. 41-35 is Naz Reid over to Air Wiggins for 3. Nothing but net for the former Rock Chalk Jayhawk. As there's Miles Bridges answering right back with a 3 of his own. Hornets only down by 4 now. Nice layup from Jarrett Culver, who led all scorers in this game with 34 points. As Culver getting his own board and the putback. It's now 50-42. Here's Chris Dunn trying to beat the buzzer. Instead, he loses it. Bridges with the steal over to the rookie Isaiah Mobley for the one-handed dunk. That's how the first half would end. On to the second. Michael Porter Jr. with the fadeaway. Quiet first half for Porter, but he picked it up in the second half. Very efficient game in this one for MPJ. As there's Cat, two defenders on him, but he's making it look easy. And then LaVar Ball once said, stay in your lane. But there's nobody in the lane. Edwards able to take advantage with the dunk. Then here's PJ Washington for 3. Solid game in this one for PJ. He's been quiet this year after putting up 18 a game as a rookie last season. As Wiggins gets the dunk, 50-63. Washington over to Justice Winslow. May there be justice on your soul. 62-56. Graham back to Winslow. Nothing but net for the former Duke Blue Devil. Hornets only down by 5. Jake Lehman, the white boy, misses the layup, gets his own board, and puts it back in. Lehman originally drafted by the Trailblazers, now here with Minnesota. As there's Devontae Graham with the steal. Big 12 battle, as you can see. Graham and Culver. Kansas is obviously better, but it's the Maryland Terrapin, Bruno Fernando, who puts it back in. And then Culver, wide open for 3. Isaiah Mobley doesn't even put a hand in his face. And then there's Culver again in the corner. He makes the 3, and he is red hot right now. And why not keep a hot streak up? Jarrett Culver going upstairs where Grandma hides the cookies. Now the floater is off, but Montrezl Harrell puts it back in. 80-70 now our score. Nice drive from Jarrett Culver. He gets the and one. Michael Porter Jr. with the foul as Culver is looking like a young Kobe Bryant right now. He just looks unstoppable. Ferris Edwards with another steal over to Michael Porter Jr. for the dunk. Hornets only down by 9. This here's Culver with a beauty as he has the dimer for a reason, getting it to Cat for the dunk. And then Culver misses the layup. Towns with the board. He's blocked. Not in my house, says Michael Porter Jr. And then Edwards with a nice pass from Bruno Fernando gets the dunk. Now 85-78. Here's Winslow over to Miles Bridges in the corner, and it's good. So Charlotte cuts the lead to 4. Now look at this. Culver, despite having Edwards smothering him, drains the 3. Big bucket for Minnesota. 90-81. Hornets need a bucket, and they get just that. Michael Porter Jr., top of the key 3, making it a 6-point game. Cat with the two-handed powerful slam. Now an 8-point game, but a big and 1. Naz Reid fouls Anthony Edwards. Bad foul from Reid, by the way. So the Hornets are able to make it a 5-point deficit, but Jared Culver immediately answers right back with a dunk. 96-91. Nice play inside from Wiggins. Timberwolves looking good. Hornets need a miracle, and that helps. Miles Bridges with the and 1. It's only a 2-point game now. Edwards steals it from Dunn, and we are tied up. Edwards with the dunk. Charlotte is right back in this game. Towns misses. Mobley with the board. Here comes Charlotte going coast to coast. Bridges just blowing by Chris Dunn, saying, I'm done with losing. And he gives Charlotte their first lead of the game. 47 and a half seconds left. Minnesota going to inbound it. As here's Towns. He loses it. And that'll be out on Karl-Anthony Towns. So Charlotte gets the ball back. They just need to be smart with it and not do anything stupid. Anthony Edwards misses the easy layup. Hornet fans cannot believe it. And here's Jarrett Culver. He gets the and one. So Minnesota has the chance to take the lead. Michael Porter called for the foul. He does not believe it. This time Edwards makes the layup. Hornets up by 1. This is where things get interesting. Minnesota has to inbound it. Here's Andrew Wiggins. Short mid-range shot. It's good. 8.3 seconds left. Minnesota up by 1. Can Charlotte get the win? PJ Washington inbounding it. He gets it to Anthony Edwards. Edwards trying to drive by Chris Dunn over to Miles Bridges. They call this place Buzz City, but it looks like Brick City as Bridges' shot is no good. The Charlotte Hornets with a heartbreaking 1-point loss. Miles Bridges misses the game winner, and Minnesota gets a close road win here. 103-102 is going to be the final score in this one. Charlotte does not believe that they managed to find a way to lose this game. Looking at the final box score, 27 points, 10 assists, 5 steals for Edwards. Miles Bridges did play well, to his credit. And if he didn't play as well as he did, the Hornets wouldn't have even been in the game at the end. So you can't really get too upset with him. Michael Porter Jr. was efficient. PJ Washington, nah. Bruno Fernando was pretty good. Everyone else, nothing too crazy. Only 4 points for Isaiah Mobley, who's a regular starter. And he puts up good numbers in the sim, but I just don't feel like I play that well with him in the game. I don't know why. Well, and then look at the numbers for Minnesota. They were a 3-headed monster in this game. Jarrett Culver, Andrew Wiggins, and Karl-Anthony Towns. Culver with 35, 5-5. Wiggins, 24 in the game winner. Cat, 21-10. And their next leading scorer only had 8, that being Josh Okogie. Also a busy day for Chris Dunn, whether that's good or bad for him. 7 points, 7 assists, and 6 turnovers. So now doing some more simming, we go 0-3 in our next 3, losing to the Pelicans, getting demolished by the 76ers, and then losing a close one of the Bucks, but I guess it does help the tank. So now the Hornets head to the Lone Star State, headed down to Jerry's World to take on the Dallas Mavericks, and just like the Timberwolves, a Maverick star will not be playing in this game. Kristaps Porzingis is out, and then his replacement is Michael Where's the Weed Beasley, as Anthony Edwards with the early and 1. And then there's Luka Doncic, the Slovenian sensation, with the dunk. But Charlotte off to an incredible start. The exact opposite of what happened in the Timberwolves game. Edwards with the layup, making it 13-2. And then Bridges, deep 3. Hornets up big early, 16-2. This should not be allowed. So the Mavericks need to get back in this game. Jalen Brunson, the former Villanova Wildcat, with the layup, 18-8. Quick release from Edwards, it's no good, but Washington with a board over to Miles Bridges for the dunk. London Bridges is falling down, just like that shot. And then there's Doncic. Beautiful pass to Jalen Brunson. Big games in this one for Brunson and Doncic. As Michael Porter Jr. all up in Luka's face, he nails it. That's why he's one of the best young players in the NBA. Now Luka going for the floater, no good. But Boban's there. Hi, I is Boban. I like board. I like cookie. Boban Marjanovic with the board and the putback, and then Doncic with the layup. 28-21, Doncic gets it to Maxi Kleber, the Germany native. As you can tell, this Mavericks team filled with European studs. Here's Luka Doncic with the dunk, former number 3 overall pick of the Atlanta Hawks, traded on a draft day trade to Dallas in exchange for Trae Young. As Miles Bridges hits the 3, 37-35. Edwards over to Justice Winslow. More wide open than a Burger King drive-thru at 5:30 in the morning. Changing it up a little bit with that one. As Bridges misses the 3, Edwards is under it for the board. Over to Michael Porter Jr. Back to Edwards. Deep 3. Brunson in his face, but it doesn't matter. Anthony Edwards is money from range. And then Miles Bridges puts that young man on a poster. Jalen Brunson, his career is over. Press F to pay respects for Mr. Brunson. 49-41, Hardaway Jr. misses the layup. Nice defense from Charlotte. I don't know why that was in the video because it's unimportant. As Miles Bridges with the dunk, 51-41. Another steal. Charlotte's defense has been playing good basketball these past couple of games. Edwards over to Miles Bridges in the corner. Green release, nothing but net. Hornets up by 11. Here's Bridges with the dunk. And Miles Bridges, one of the best dunkers in the NBA. Participated in the NBA dunk contest his first 2 years. Probably going to participate in it again this year. As Curry hits the 3, not Steph. That's his younger brother, Seth. As there's Dwight Powell with the dunk. And then Tim Hardaway Jr., easy 3. Nobody was miles from him, and he takes advantage. 58-55 now. Mavericks right back in this game. Hornets need a bucket, and they get just that. Michael Porter Jr. hits the 3. 61-57 until Jalen Brunson had something to say about that. Brunson cuts the lead down to 1. 63-61. Luka Doncic will tie the game up with a beautiful slam. 63-60. Pump fake from Brunson. His layup will give Dallas the lead. 67-69, giggity. Edwards will tie the game up with a nice dunk. Now Dallas up by 4. Charlotte needs a bucket. There's the big fella, Bruno Fernando, for 3. Hornets only down by 1. But Luka, he makes buckets, except for that one. But Boban's right under it to get the board. So either Luka makes the shot, or Boban gets the putback. And that's all you got to do if you're the Mavericks. So a 4-point game, big 3 for Charlotte, cutting the lead down to 1, 80-81. Steph Curry having trouble with it. Curry with a beautiful dime right on time. That's Michael Beasley, 420, wears the weed. As Luka Doncic, nice shot over the head of a Hornet defender, 82-86. Another big 3 ball from Jalen Nowell this time. And then the Mavericks getting an and-1. Dwight Powell with the play, 85-91 now. Miles Bridges trying to drive inside. No good, but Bruno Fernando right there to get the putback. Hornets only down by 4. They've stayed in this game. Edwards now with a nifty layup. No foul there, 95-97. Bridges for the lead, and he is money. Bridges gives the Charlotte Hornets a 1-point lead. So Covington over to Michael Beasley, no good. But Rocco is getting loco. Big fourth quarter in this one for Robert Covington. More on him in just a bit. 98-101. There's PJ Washington with a long 2. Not quite going to tie it up. 100-101. Mavericks trying to put the ice in the dagger, and that'll certainly help. Jalen Brunson gets the dunk. 100-105. Brunson loses it, but Robert Covington steals it. And then there's some miscommunication on defense from the Hornets. Covington hits the 3 ball. 104-110. Hornets need a miracle again. Miles Bridges with the dunk. Hornets only down by 4, so it's still possible. But the Mavericks only need one shot to end it, and they do just that. Rocco is getting loco. Robert Covington trying to end this game. Hornets just going to heave up some prayers at this point. Graham over to Nowell. He makes it. So it's only a 4-point game. Dallas will make their 3 throws. Devontae Graham heaves it up. You might as well call him Kim Jong-un because he's launching nukes. So if Tim Hardaway misses both of these 3 throws, the Hornets still have a chance. But he's not going to do that. He finishes 2 for 2 from the line. ice in his veins. And the Dallas Mavericks get the win, 112-117. Big games in this one from Luka and Jalen Brunson. Robert Covington with a nice fourth quarter as Doncic and Brunson combined for 57. Hardaway and Powell also scored double figures, and Michael Beasley was obviously smoking a stash of that good stuff during the halftime break. 30 points for Bridges, 26 for Edwards, and Graham, Noel, and Washington all in double figures. So at this point of the year, we're about halfway through. Charlotte's not going to make the playoffs, most likely. So now it's time to take a look at the potential draft class. Charlotte should be getting a high pick again, and I think we're only one or two pieces away from really developing a great team. And this is a really deep draft class, by the way. So looking at the mock drafts, Draft Express has the Hornets going with Evan Mobley, who is the brother of Isaiah Mobley, so that's kind of fitting. 2K has the Hornets going with Terrence Clark, and NBA.com has them going with Cade Cunningham, currently the projected number one overall pick out of Texas. So that'll do it for the video. Make sure you guys like and subscribe for more Hornets My League. Have a good one. Peace out.